There's a natural mystic flowing through the air. If you listen carefully, now you will hear. This could be the first trumpet, might as well be the last. Many more will have to struggle, many more will have to die. Don't ask me why. Hi guys, this is How to Play Natural Mystic by Bob Marley, part of a series of mastering minor chords, which are E minor, A minor, and D minor, the three easiest minor chords to play on guitar. The main trick to this song, the chord changes aren't that fast, there's not too many chords in this song, but the strumming pattern is very odd. It's what we call offbeat chips. So we're strumming rather than on a count of 1, 2, 3, 4, we're strumming on every and. So in between every count of 4, in between each number, there is an and. A 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. And we're going to strum a downstroke on those ands and mute to start off with on the beat, but we actually want these strums to be as short as possible. If you listen to the record, the little strums barely even sound like a guitar, and this is a big feature of reggae music, where it's not just 1 and 2 and 3 and, where we're kind of muting on the beat, which is a bit more of a classic rock thing to do, or an acoustic thing to do. For reggae, we want it to sound as short as possible. So 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. Really weird when you first start doing it, because of course so far I've pretty much trained you to strum on the beat and to nod your head and tap your foot and your strumming hand to be going on that count of 4. So this is kind of going to be fighting against your natural instincts, but this is good. This means that we'll be able to mix and match on and off beats and kind of command your strumming a little bit more rather than relying on a count or the beat. To start off with, if you can just play it at the correct time without actually having to count, that may be easier, and it may be a much better way to go about it rather than mastering the count first, which we kind of had to do for your normal 4-4 strumming. We were counting at the same time. But for this, if you just want to join into me, we are palm muting here. So this is palm muting, where we want to stop your guitar, stop the sound altogether. So basically, after the strum, you want to do a mini karate chop over your sound hole, or if you have an electric guitar, over where your pickups are. And you want your hand to go down so that it stops all the strings vibrating and that stops the sound. I'm just going to hold down this A minor chord the whole time. However, as a higher level technique, if you can strum and mute, and when you mute, relax your fingers and only press down. I think you can see that. Only press down when you're strumming and when you want a sound to be heard. It means you're always relaxing this hand, and this hand doesn't get really tense, so that can be really cool. But to start off with, if you want to hold down just an A minor chord and try and strum at the same time as me and mute when I do, just copy as you hear. So 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and. To a count of 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. It's the strangest thing when you first start doing it, but it's the biggest feature of reggae music, and this idea is borrowed for loads of other styles as well. As I say, from classic rock to normal acoustic music to pop music. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. And pause there. That's the rhythm guitar part that we want for this song. if that is still very different for you, it's very new, I really recommend you just play along to the song with just an A minor. It will sound absolutely fine. We want to get your rhythm content here, and this is just an example of a song where we're going to be using minor chords, but these offbeat chips are really vital for your strumming hand development, and you're picking hand development. So when he starts singing, we do go to a D minor, and there's a little part where we go D minor for two strums, E minor for two, and then A minor for a whole bar. So, two, two, and four. Two D minors, two E minors, and then four A minors. As I say, if you are struggling with keeping up with the changes and everything, just get this offbeat chip rhythm along to the record and join in where you hear it, the little one, and two, and three. Just strum as you hear it. Don't worry too much about the count, because if you can do it without having to count at all, it's actually better. If you can start to get that would be really great. It means that you really get this stuff. But from the top, if we just stay on the A minor to start off with, to get your groove, and four, and one, and two, and three, making sure that your mute is completely deadening all your strings, so it's silence, rather than that, and then in one, two, to a D minor, there's a natural mystic E minor to A minor. Same riff again, D minor, straight to E minor, and A minor. One more time, D minor, E minor, and A minor. Pause there. This could be the first trumpet, is just D minor, back to A minor, two and two. Two Ds, and two As. Two Ds, two As. This could be the first trumpet, might as well be the last. Many more. Just keep repeating that same D minor, A minor, from the top. Don't ask me why. Stays on A minor when it gets to Don't Ask Me Why. Okay, so join in with me with this A minor, and three, and four, and one, and two. Just that A minor to start off with, and then we'll go for your D minor, E minor, A minor verse section. There's a D minor to E minor, back to A. Same again. D, E minor, and A minor. Just D minor to A minor. D to A, D to A, D to A. One more time. And stay on A minor. And two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three. And stop there. Very cool. If we take away that strumming pattern and just do it as we've strummed any other song, just four down strums on the beat, it becomes D minor, E minor, and A minor. It loses all the rhythm guitar content, all the song content. It doesn't sound like a reggae song anymore. There's a natural mystic flowing through the air. It's, you know, it's still reminiscent of the song, but it kind of kills the feel of it. It kills the groove. So, as I say, as a priority, I really want you to get these offbeat chips sounding really great. Make sure you're strumming the thinner strings on your A minor rather than the thickest one, and it will sound a lot nicer. If it's sounding a bit like this, that's because you're playing the thicker strings. You want to stay on at least the top four, and kind of the more thinner strings you can hit, the better, if they're all ringing out and sounding nice and sad. That's how to play Natural Mystic, and that's an introduction to reggae strumming and a reggae style of music on guitar. Thanks for checking out this video. Please subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you like what I do. If you do have any requests as well, please get in touch, give us a message, leave a comment below this video, and hopefully I'll be able to play a song for you.